Thank you. Thank you very much. Anyone recognize that song? Anyone? No? Yeah, it's called Things Can Only Get Better. It's by a guy named Howard Jones from the 80s, I think about 1986 or so. This is great. I love this intimate audience. I don't even really need this mic, but I like the way it makes my voice sound. So I'm going to continue to use it, if you don't mind. Just indulge my delusions of grandeur, if you will. So we're Kings of the Lobby. My name's Chris. This is Paul and Jeremy and Tim. And yeah, thank you very much. So we're a jazz funk outfit. I founded this group in 2015, and we've been going strong ever since. And so this is kind of my outlet to play funk and pop style. Oh, by the way, could I get just a little bit more in my monitor of saxophone? Thank you. So we like to play music from the 70s, 80s, and 90s, but we do it in sort of my arrangements of it, so we sort of twist them around a little bit and open them up for jazz improvisation and stuff like that. We're going to continue with a Toto song. This is one of their, I think this went to the top of the charts. I think this was number one back in about 1983. This is called Rosanna. you very much. Thank you very much. We're going to continue with something that I just put together a few months ago. This is an arrangement of the Christopher Cross. This definitely was a number one hit. This is Sailing. Everybody knows this song, Sailing. Remember Sailing? This song holds a special place for me as a kid. Just one of the first pop songs I remember hearing, and I just, whenever I hear the song, it just brings back just the earliest possible memories for me. And so it's got a special place somewhere in the deep recesses of my psyche. You'll notice we change things up a little bit with this. You'll recognize it, but it's got a little bit of a curveball thrown in there. So this is it's going to feature Paul and Jeremy on the drums. This is Sailing. Thank you. How about it for Paul on the piano? Well, keyboard. And Jeremy on the drums. So I don't need to remind everyone about the torturous year of 2016 when we lost all those great celebrities, especially in music. But David Bowie was one of the people that we lost that year. And back the year before when I started this group, I wrote a David Bowie medley. This is two of his funk songs. I wanted to sort of get a sampling of his 1970s funk and then how that contrasts with his 80s funk. And so we're gonna go from Fame into Let's Dance. It's a David Bowie medley. And I wrote this for David Bowie when he was still alive, and it just kind of turned into this tribute after he passed. Ooh, jazzy. It turned into a tribute after his passing. And so this is of course for David Bowie, but we hope you enjoy. This is Fame and Let's Dance.
Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. We're gonna do a song by Stevie Wonder, who I don't think it's controversial to say Stevie belongs in the echelon of great geniuses in any field, especially music, but for sure Bach, Mozart, John Coltrane, Miles Davis, Stevie Wonder, James Brown. I don't have any problem putting those people together, and I don't think any of the rest of us would either. I mean, his genius is undeniable. So we're going to do something of his called Boogie On, Reggae Woman.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you. Before we take a brief intermission, we're going to play one more for you. This is brand new, and it's kind of more of experimental. So if you'll indulge us a little bit, are you willing to do that with us? Yeah? Okay, take a ride with us. Take a ride through weird land with us. Well, that remains to be seen, I guess. This is something that I recently put together. This is a Genesis, 1980s Genesis song called Tonight, Tonight, Tonight. And this is kind of a mashup with a Tears for Fears song called Shout. So we call this Tonight We Shout. And this is a mashup of those two songs. But before we play, I'd like to reintroduce you to the fine musicians on stage. Very, very lucky to have these gentlemen behind me backing me up. I'm backing you up. Backing me up tonight. But this over here, Paul Mutzabaugh on the keyboard. Paul Mutzabaugh. Tim Seisser on the bass. The very young Jeremy Warren over here. Jeremy's a talented young man. I won't give away your age, but he's definitely the baby of the group, and I can remember a time when I was the baby of the group, and it's nice to sort of, you know, this is what we do in jazz. We mentor, we bring people in, and I love playing with younger musicians, the fire, the energy, the raw talent and all that stuff. It's awesome. So we're very, very happy to have everybody here, and we're very happy to have all of you here too. By the way, does everyone like what they're hearing tonight? Are you enjoying yourselves? Well, I've got some good news for you. We are selling CDs. Sorry to break it to you like that, but we are. And I hate being a shameless self-promoter, but the CDs are for sale. We did get them done. They're studio recordings of lots of the music you're hearing here tonight. And if you like what you hear, all you got to do is talk to your friendly bartender, and you will get set straight on the CDs. $10 a CD. It's an amazing bargain for a dying medium. Sad but true. But nevertheless, it works. Most of us still have CD players in our cars, so there you go. On the ride home, pop us on in. So this is Tonight We Shout. Thank you. Mutzabaugh. That's Paul Mutzabaugh on the keyboard. That's Tim Seisser on the bass. Jeremy Warren on the drums. I'm Chris Madsen. We're Kings of the Lobby. We're going to take a break and give this floor back to Steve, but we want to thank you for being here. Thanks, everybody.
That's a Kings of the Lobby right there. Kings of the Lobby. That's Chris Madsen, Paul Mutzabaugh, Tim Seisser, and Jeremy Warren. Thank you so much. Please do stick around. The bar is now open. We're going to have a brief intermission and conversation with these guys and more music. Thanks. Thanks, fellas. So as I mentioned before, the show started, we've got this great relationship with WDCB, and so as part of the broadcast that we do on Tuesday nights, Chicago Jazz Live, we have a little conversation with the artists. So this evening, I am so excited to have Chris Madsen here.
I'm excited to be here.
Fellow with a great radio voice.
you said that before, and it really means a lot to me, you know, because I don't get to hear myself on a sound system of this quality very often. On speaking, I don't get to hear my voice amplified through this lovely system with all this professional equipment. So it's a treat, and for you to say that, I appreciate that.
Well, it's not just the microphone, my friend.
No, not at all.
No, it's your melodious, sonorous voice.
Thank you.
So I had a couple of questions that I was going to ask you before the show started,
because
I've known you for a while, and I've known the kind of groups you bring in here, and I've always loved them. And then you played, and then I threw all those out the window, and I had totally different questions.
Sure, yeah.
The questions that I had, actually, well, I will ask just a couple of basic things. Mm-hmm. You said you started this group in 2015.
Yeah.
I know, and you the last time you were here, you also had some younger players playing with you.
That's true.
And again this evening. So can you just tell me about how this group got together, where you find these incredible young players and that sort of thing?
Yeah, absolutely. There's a series in Chicago called the Jazz Record Art Collective, and it takes place at this art studio on Hubbard Street, on Hubbard Street. And so in 2015, what they normally do is they will have put a group together to play a famous jazz record from top to bottom.
Yeah, exactly. Play a record from end to end, right.
And so I put together a group to play a jazz record. It was sort of a jazz funk record. It's called The Return of the Brecker Brothers.
Oh, yeah.
One of my favorite, fusion bands of all time. And so I put a group together to play that record, and then I said, wow, this was great. You guys nailed it, and it was so fun to play with you. Let's do this more,
Uh-huh.
And so I had a bunch of these kind of tunes milling around in my head, and I just thought, wow, what if I sort of open these up a little bit and arrange them and sort of put a jazz spin to them? And so that's it. And then I just started to book some gigs, and that was it.
Wow.
The rest is history.
Wow. So I love that you've just kind of going back to your, or I mean, we all can go back to our early days as musicians or non-musicians, the first stuff that really strikes us, that moves us or makes us laugh, or some kind of music that affects us somehow emotionally.
Definitely.
And you have kind of latched on to a lot of that. It sounds like the stuff that meant a lot to you as a younger player and just a younger person.
Yeah, absolutely.
And brought those forward and put a contemporary spin on them.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I describe it to my friends as like a nostalgia band. It's a nostalgia band because a lot of these songs, they hold special significance for me. Obviously, I choose them because I want to work with those songs. I mean, I wouldn't choose songs I didn't want to work with, but these are songs that I listened to as a kid or I discovered as an adult. And some of the songs I even experienced live. We do some stuff, I don't think we've done any 90s tonight, but we have some 90s stuff that we do that I remember from high school and that I grew up with, and I have these attachments to these songs. Mm-hmm. So, it's basically a nostalgia group for me, and these guys interpret and indulge my nostalgia, and I'm very thankful to them for
and
that.
And they're younger, so that they this is not their nostalgia.
Yeah, definitely. Well, some of them, but definitely. If they're younger, they probably are learning about this stuff for the first time, and so you could say that I'm sort of in a way. Bringing this music to a younger generation, making sure that it lives on.
That's it.
This great
so you're
pop and rock
thing,
music.
Good thing for the world.
Saving
the world one older tune at a time.
Yeah, sure. Why not? Let's go ahead and say that.
Right, sure. Let's go with that one. One of the things that was striking me, and this is what was what was making me rethink what I was going to talk about out here was the incredible amount of colors coming from these other guys.
Oh, yeah.
And this is really an incredible band. I mean, Paul Mutzabaugh and Tim Seisser, the keyboard player and the bass player, which for our radio audience they can't see, but they're like mad scientists here. Tim has got, I can't count, but there's 45 or 50 pedals in front of him. Yeah. Easy. And Paul's got equally as many knobs and buttons on. Yeah. And you know, I've always thought of electronics and music as it can quickly become gimmicky, and it is certainly not any. It's not any of that here. It's interesting colors. I mean, music is just sound organized, and anything can be, you know, can make music if it's treated right.
Yeah.
And these guys are so artful in the way that they're like mining sounds from these instruments.
Yeah.
And the effects in a way that doesn't strike me in any way as a gimmick.
No, I don't think so. And I think a lot of that's due, not to sound snobby or anything, but a lot of that is due to the jazz training that these guys have, you know, because I think the music that they have sort of been trained to play, or at least started playing, or have a sort of one foot in that world. Jazz is such a music that responds in the moment, and as an accompanist, you're taught to be as delicate as the soloist warrants, you know, and so you have to provide the best accompaniment that works at that specific moment. And so they're not going to get too loud, they're not going to get too forceful if that's not what they feel the soloist needs, or if that's not what the music serves. They're very sensitive. They're very sensitive rhythm section in that sense. They're just responding to the needs of the moment.
Yeah.
And that's a jazz thing, I must say.
Well, and I've always felt that the best players are the best listeners.
Oh, yeah. You know? No question about
and,
it. No question.
Boy, it really comes through these players. And
definitely.
As well for Jeremy Warren.
Oh, of course.
I don't even want to know how old he is. But
yeah,
he
you don't want to know.
But
it would just depress all of us to know
exactly.
That.
I would drink more.
Definitely. Yeah. But, hear that, Jeremy. You're driving us to drink out here, Jeremy.
But it is an impressive group, and as are you. It's such an impressive player.
Thank you very much, Steve.
To hear you and to see you, and I'm going to get off the stage so we can hear you play more.
Yeah,
all
thanks.
Right,
thank you, Steve.
Hey, Chris Madsen, Kings of the Lobby.
Thanks. All right, pardon me. Sorry. We're going to do, I caught you off guard there, we're going to do a kind of another medley. This is two tunes that have similar titles, so let's see if anyone can figure out the medley. That'll be your homework assignment during this. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Thank you. So does anyone have the medley? Yes, in the front row. You got it. Black Friday and Black Velvet. You get an honorary CD. How about that? Yeah, we should do Black Cow. That's a good idea. Yeah, two Steely Dan for the price of one. Thank you very much. That's great. We're going to do a couple more. We're going to continue with an Anita Baker song. This is something that people sort of known as the Quiet Storm genre of R&B, a 1980s R&B Quiet Storm, something you'd hear on the radio at 2 a.m. after someone does a shout out to their loved one, you know, over the radio. So this is called Caught Up in the Rapture. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. How about one more time for Jeremy Warren on the drums, Tim Seisser on the bass, Paul Mutzabaugh on the keyboard. We have one more for you. This is a song by Prince, but the most famous recording is not by Prince, it's by Chaka Khan. Anyone know this one yet? Of course, I feel for you. Yeah, if you feel like getting up and cutting a rug, please, by all means, there's a rug right here. And I think Steve has some scissors. Oh, anyway, that's all right. He's doing okay. Yes. Yeah, don't cut it. Okay. This one's going to feature Jeremy especially, but all of us to some extent. So I hope you enjoy I Feel For You. This is on our CD, which is for sale over there by the door. Thank you.
Oh,
Mutzabaugh, Tim Seisser, Jeremy Warren. I'm Chris Madsen. We're Kings of the Lobby. We got CDs for you. Thank you, Steve Rashid. Thank you, Sam, back in the booth. Thanks for everyone coming out tonight. Have a wonderful evening. Thanks.
Kings of the Lobby, ladies and gentlemen. I don't care where the lobby is. These guys are the kings. Of the lobby. Thanks so much to these fine gentlemen for a wonderful evening of art. Thanks to all of you for coming and supporting this. And please have a safe trip home. Come visit us again, please.